Greetings, and welcome to another episode of Masterworks of Video Game Music. This time we will be exploring the original music to Masato Nakamura's score to the 1991 Sega Genesis masterpiece, Sonic the Hedgehog. Sonic the Hedgehog was released by Sega as a foil to compete with Nintendo's Super Mario Bros. Series. The character became so popular as a more edgier version of Mario that Sonic soon became the flagship game for the system. The platforming gameplay is very similar to Super Mario Bros., though the superior graphics and speed that the Sega Genesis could produce as opposed to the Nintendo Entertainment System quickly won players over and established Sonic as an iconic video game character. Ironically, when Nintendo acquired the rights to Sonic after Sega went bankrupt, the character frequently appeared with Mario in many subsequent games. Sonic the Hedgehog's music was composed by then first-time video game composer Masato Nakamura. Prior to his involvement with Sega, Nakamura was, and still is, a member of the Japanese pop group Dreams Come True, in which he played bass and produced many of their songs. The executives at Sega appreciated Nakamura's fast and edgy pop tunes and invited him to compose original tracks for Sonic. Nakamura did not wish to treat Sonic as a mere video game, but composed the music as if it were a film score due to its strong storyline. Unfortunately, Nakamura only had screenshots of the game available, as Sonic was still in pre-development. This proved to be a difficult task, as Nakamura did not have access to any live footage. Therefore, Nakamura used the color in each picture to imagine what the music would sound like based on the environment. The Marble Zone theme in particular was taken from the presence of volcanic lava that Sonic must avoid throughout the stages. The Labyrinth Zone theme was inspired by the aquatic landscape that Sonic must navigate through without drowning. After a certain time period, a more suspenseful theme takes over when Sonic begins to run out of air. This lasts for 5 seconds unless Sonic can take a breath from a bubble or escape the water. If the time runs out, Sonic will drown and the player will lose a life. The drowning theme has become iconic in itself as music that players dread whenever they have to go through a water level. Nakamura was able to use the Sega Drive's limited music capabilities to great effect. Like the original Nintendo Entertainment System, composers could only access 4 separate music channels, one for melodic content, another for countermelodies, one for a bass line, and a noise channel for percussion effects. Since Nakamura was not used to these limitations due to his background as a pop songwriter, it was challenging for him to conform to these standards while writing for Sonic. The Green Hill Zone music that opens up the gameplay has become nearly as familiar to gamers as the opening stage of Super Mario Bros. Players immediately noticed the faster, more pop-driven sound that corresponded to the rapid gameplay created by Sonic Speed. Throughout the game's 6 major levels, the music is similar in that it all demonstrates the same contemporary pop style, which prolongs the excitement and energy that the Sonic series is known for. The only major contrast to this is the special stage, where Sonic can visit to collect the Chaos Emeralds. The music is set to a waltz-like feel in 3/4 time, which is designed to create confusion as Sonic spins around a rotating environment looking for the emerald. If you would like to delve deeper into the music theory and specific compositional techniques of Sonic the Hedgehog, I recommend checking out the 8-Bit Music Theory YouTube channel, which has a variety of excellent videos on that and many other games. Nakamura would also write the music for Sonic the Hedgehog 2 in a similar style, but would not continue for Sonic 3 due to contract disputes. Both games have gone down in gaming history as 2 of the greatest games ever created, and there are currently over 60 games that feature the character of Sonic. Perhaps Nakamura could be persuaded to step back into the composer's chair for a future title? Well, time will tell, but in the meantime, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe for future videos. Until then, I'm Professor Lesser, and I'll see you next time.